Hi, welcome to eMedia Coach. I'm your expert instructor for the Astra Pro theme, and today I'm going to talk to you about the Block Pro module, which is available to Astra Pro users. If you are still using the free version of the Astra theme and you want to buy the Pro version of the Astra theme, then you can go to emediacoach.com/astra, and then you'll be redirected to the Astra's website where you can buy the Pro version of the theme. So let's go to our test site and let's log into our dashboard. Now let's go to appearance and then go to Astra options. Here you'll find a variety of modules available to the Astra Pro users, and if you don't have the option to activate them, then that means that you are using the free version of the theme and you need to upgrade it to the Pro version using the link I gave in the description, or you can directly go to emediacoach.com/astra. So let's begin this tutorial. So in this tutorial I'm going to walk you through to the Block Pro module of Astra Pro theme. So using this feature we can change how our block page appears on our website. So let's go to our website and see how does the block page appear right now. So this is how our block page is appearing right now, but we can fully customize it. So let me show you how you can do that. So before we start, let me show you the customized page. So let's go to layout and then go to blog. And now you can see that there are two options available to us. And when I go to blog/archive, you'll see that there are a few options available. Now if I go and activate this feature here, the Block Pro module, and I go there and refresh this page, let's go to layout, then blog, and then blog/archive. So as you can see, the functions have increased there because of activation of this module, and now you have much more control over the block page of your website. So let me show you what are the uses and benefits of these all features which we are having now. So as you can see, currently we are having a grid layout in which there is one grid and the grids are appearing one after another. So if I change this to two columns, you'll see that there are two posts appearing next to each other. So this is the first post, this is the second post. And similarly, you can add space between the posts. So this space has been added between the posts. And similarly, you can increase it to 3 columns or 4 columns, but I'll keep it 2 because 2 looks good. Now you can see that there is space appearing here because the lengths of these two posts are not equal. So let's click on masonry effect and you'll see that the space is utilized by adding up another post. So as you can see, without any coding we can fully customize this, and this looks beautiful and excellent. So similarly, you can add highlight first post, or you can make it a featured post. So a special highlight will be added to the first post. As you can see, the fonts have become bolder from compared to other posts. Now let's disable this because it's not much of value. Similarly, if you want to show the publishing date on the blog post, then you can click on enable date box. You'll see a date option here. And if you want to customize it, you can just make it a circle or a square. And if you want to make this image full size, then you can just click on remove featured image padding and this image will be shifted to full size. So this looks excellent now. This is how a blog page should be appearing on a website. Now let's go to other option. So the blog post content should be an excerpt or the full content. For those people who don't know what excerpt is, it is a short summary of the blog post, and I'll show you how you can do that. So let's go to our website. And let's go to blog. Let's go to this post. And let's click on edit post. So as you can see, this is the content of our blog post and this is the heading. So if you want to add an excerpt to it, just copy a small summary of your blog post or write it yourself, and then you can go here and add an excerpt to the blog post and then click on update. So this is how you can add an excerpt to the blog post. And if you want to show only the excerpt, then you can show it using this. And you can also add a count that this is the maximum number of words or letters should be appearing here. Or you can also choose to show the full content of the blog post so that no read more button will be appearing. And if you want to customize the read more button here, you can add it as a button, and you can display text as read. And similarly, there are many functionalities you can use it for. Now, post pagination, you can edit a number or an infinite scroll. In the numbers, if you have more and more posts, then a number will be appearing here, like 1, 2, 3, ... 100. And if you have an infinite scroll, what will happen is that whenever you scroll, more and more posts will be appearing one after another. So it depends on your own choice that what type of thing you want to keep on your website. So these are the features available for the Astra Pro people, and these options here are available to the free users as well. Using these features, like, you can just hide the featured image if you want, or you can hide the title and the meta blog. So these are just various features available for all the users, and these are the pro features. And similarly, if you want to customize the size of your featured images, these images, then you can do it by using this size, but I'll recommend you not to modify this, because this looks good and I don't think there is a need to modify that. Similarly, you can add a blog content width to default or custom. Custom means like you can set the width of the blog. So as you can see, the blog page width has been decreased, but I'll recommend you to keep it default because it looks good that way. So this was all about the Blog Pro module of the Astra Pro theme. And in the next videos, I'm going to talk to you about these all other features. So if you like this video, press the thumbs icon below and subscribe to this channel, because I'm going to create more and more videos related to Astra Pro and WordPress. If you have any questions or suggestions, you can directly put them in the comment box below, or you can also go to our website emediacoach.com, or you can check the link in the description, and from there you can contact us using the email or the contact form. Thank you for watching this video.